select audiences award for distinction. This is Channel 4 WSM-TV, Nashville.
Next Charlie Rose show, one of television's favorite personalities, Merv Griffin.
See, I spent the decade of the 60s in New York, which had to be the most exciting time for talk shows ever. A lot more things happen in New York than in Hollywood. The attitude of the guests and the studio audience
Merv
is different.
Merv Griffin on the next Charlie Rose show. Join us.
From Channel 4, this is a news update. Here is Terry Merriman.
Good morning. The forecast calls for pleasant voting weather. The polls opened at 7 this morning. Today's high is expected to be in the upper 60s. Right now, our radar, as it scans across the state, 150 miles in all directions, shows all is clear. A tiny bit of precipitation to the east of us as it moves out of our state, 55 degrees outside our studio. Registrars around the state predict a voter turnout today in Tennessee of about 1 million. The race generating the most interest this year is also Tennessee's most hotly contested, the presidential sweepstakes among President Carter, Ronald Reagan, John Anderson, and a few other independents. Polls and politicians have rated Tennessee a toss-up between Reagan and Carter. The past seven presidential elections, Tennessee has gone Republican five times. All eight incumbent U.S. representatives are up for re-election, and 115 state senators and representatives will be chosen. Democrat Jane Eskin of Nashville is unopposed in her bid to become the first woman on the three-member Public Service Commission. According to local Democratic and Republican campaign politicians and workers, the hostage developments won't hinder either President Carter or Ronald Reagan in capturing the presidential nomination. Valerie Hyman has more.
Mrs. Wallace, my name is Harry Slade with the Reagan campaign.
In their last hours of campaigning in Middle Tennessee, Reagan workers said to believe the hostages should not be a campaign issue. But the regional political director for Reagan quickly predicted if recent developments in Iran make any difference, it will be in Reagan's favor. Not surprisingly, Democrats agreed. As they ended a last-day swing through five Tennessee cities, state Democratic leaders claimed if anyone benefits from changes in the hostage situation, it will be President Carter.
President Carter has been right all along in his policy of applying economic sanctions, in his policy of isolating Iran diplomatically from the other nations of the world because of their criminal act, really, in taking our hostages.
But Sasser also said he believes few votes will actually change because of the hostages. He added, however, it will draw attention to what he said has been President Carter's first priority since the hostages were taken 1 year ago, to get them all back. All safe. Valerie Hyman, Channel 4 News.
State Senator Ed Gillick resumes testifying today while his constituents go to the polls to decide whether the Democratic lawmaker returns to the legislature. Gillick faces extortion and bribery charges in federal court in Memphis and has not campaigned during the trial. He's favored to win re-election. He testified yesterday. Gillick is accused of extorting $20,000 from four men who wanted master's electrician's licenses. The jobless rate in Tennessee continued to fall in September, but even after the decline, the figures were the highest for September since 1975. Officials said the jobless rate fell to 6.9% in September. That was down from 7.5% in August. Officials said the figures indicate that the state is still in the grips of the national recession. Undergraduates at Tennessee state-related colleges may face 8% tuition increases next fall. Recommendations yesterday by the Tennessee Higher Education Commission also included an enrollment limit at the University of Tennessee at Knoxville. Both changes must be approved by the UT trustees later this month. And the pleasant weather is expected to last through the rest of the week. Right now at the airport, here's the way it looks. We have partly cloudy skies and 54 degrees. The winds are from the west at 8. Our barometer is 30.06 and falling. Our relative humidity is 80%. And the forecast for today, fair and cooler, a high of about 66. Northwest winds at 10 to 15. For today, fair, a low of 34. Northwest winds at 5 to 10. For Wednesday, fair, a high of 63. Northwest winds once again. The extended outlook for Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, highs in the mid-60s, lows in the 30s. Enjoy your day. Go out and vote. I'll be back at 8:25 with an update.
With this November 4th, NBC and Channel 4 are teaming up to bring you the fastest, most colorful election coverage ever. Join John Chancellor and David Brinkley for up-to-the-minute tallies on the national contest, and Dan Miller and Teddy Bart for local results, and Governor Lamar Alexander and Congressman Al Gore Jr. with commentary. Decision 80, brought to you by Henshaw's Ethan Allen Galleries, Third National Bank, and NLT, here on NBC and Channel 4. Terry Merriman, WSM-TV, Nashville.
Weekdays at 4, Tony Tenio gives a new look to afternoons with her own special show, with fascinating guests and interesting conversations with experts. Lots of music and your favorite stars. The Tony Tenniel Show. Then at 5, Fonzie and the gang get together for Happy Days Again. The Tony Tenniel Show at 4, followed by Happy Days Again. Weekday afternoons here on 4.
Company. Saturdays at midnight, you're on Channel 4.
From Channel 4, this is a news update. Here is Terry Merriman.
Good morning. Highs in the 60s for voting today. The polls are already open, and many in Middle Tennessee have already made the effort to get out this morning. Right now, our radar, as it scans 150 miles across the state, shows all is clear. We have 60 degrees outside our studio. Republican Governor Lamar Alexander told reporters after voting early this morning in Nashville that he cast his ballot for the GOP side of the ticket. Alexander said he voted for Governor Reagan for president, and he said even though most people are predicting a tight presidential race in Tennessee, he believes Governor Reagan and George Bush will carry the state. The governor also said he doesn't believe those people who are saying there will be a low voter turnout today. Alexander said he found a great deal of interest in all the races as he was campaigning across Tennessee. And more than 1.4 million Tennessee voters are expected to go to the polls today to help choose a president. There's no clear-cut favorite in today's election in the volunteer state or the nation at large. The Tennessee winner gets 10 electoral votes. President Carter's Southern strategy will be tested by Republican Ronald Reagan's conservative view of government. Democrats used a regional appeal in last day campaigning. They asked voters if they wanted a Hollywood actor or a person from Georgia in the White House. Republicans hit on the economy, saying paychecks can't stand 4 more years of President Carter. Meanwhile, the 52 Americans held hostage in Iran are beginning their second year of captivity today. To draw attention to the unresolved crisis, a 24-hour vigil is being maintained in Union City. The Ministerial Association in the West Tennessee town has declared today Hostage Day. Plans call for most of Iron County churches to open their doors to the public on a non-denominational basis for a 24-hour prayer vigil. The vigil began at midnight and ends at midnight tonight. Federal Judge Clure Morton has recused himself from hearing the criminal case against ousted Governor Ray Blanton and two of his former aides. Morton, Chief Judge of Middle Tennessee District, is the second federal judge to recuse himself from the case. Judge John Nixon, who was appointed to a judgeship by Blanton before being named to the federal bench, took himself off the case earlier. Blanton is charged with embarking on a scheme to restrain liquor trade in Nashville. The third Middle Tennessee judge, Tom Wiseman, is also expected to recuse himself from the case. The Tennessee Valley Authority's directors have voted to increase the utility's debt by $500 million. The vote yesterday will bring TVA's debt to more than $11 billion. Meeting in Knoxville, the directors also authorized contracts for private companies to build a solar energy computer center in Chattanooga and a nuclear plant turbine generator for TVA's Yellow Creek plant in Mississippi. Testimony yesterday showed that State Representative Emmett Ford of Memphis was the agent for at least 25 insurance firms before a 1977 accident, which prosecutors claim was staged. Ford and his wife were charged with defrauding 29 carriers of $54,000. The defense says that the Democratic lawmaker incorrectly filled out insurance applications because the forms were confusing. Weather will provide enough sunshine and warm weather to give all of us a good day to get out and vote. And let's check the forecast as it is for the rest of the week. Right now we have about 55 degrees outside the studio, fair and cooler for the rest of the day, high of 66, winds northwest at 10 to 15. And then for tonight, fair, a low of 34 degrees, winds from the northwest at 5 to 10. And then for tomorrow, fair, a high of 63 as it turns a little bit warmer toward the end of the week. Winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. And in the extended outlook for Thursday, fair skies predicted, 64 the high, 36 the low. For Friday, fair, 63 the high, 37 the low as it turns a little bit cooler toward the weekend. For Saturday, fair, 65 the high, 38 the low. No chance of rain in the forecast, even though we had a little bit earlier on last night. It was moving out of the state, as indicated by our radar this morning, and we don't expect any more. And partly cloudy skies currently at the airport. Enjoy the rest of your day to try to get out and vote, and we'll be back later with more news.
Voters, if you have questions about where to vote, who is on the ballot, or about getting a ride to the polls, call the election hotline, 297-7134.
Lonnie Lardner, WSM-TV, Nashville.
Returning by popular demand, the exciting Wheel of Fortune, the winning place to be starting Monday morning at 10, following Donahue at its new time.
Teddy and Elaine, WSM-TV, Nashville.
Is,